Oh, freaking airplane again. All right, terrible lighting and terrible everything else. It's windy outside. Just bear with me. So I'm making this video. This video is actually about this thing and the moped, so you'll want to stick around, and about Paul from Australia. So I started this video 675 days ago, and I didn't even make a video that day. I made like a 1 minute clip or less, but it's all pictures, so I'll bring those in. So 1 year and 10 months, that's how long ago, 5/20/2015, this thing right here had 16,000 miles on it, I think, when I got it. You'll see what this thing is in a minute. So a lot of you were wondering what happened to the moped, all right? Well, this video is actually about fixing this gear very interestingly. You guys will definitely want to stick around for this video. I'll try to make it quick, but I got to give you the overview. What happened to the moped? The moped exploded right around 5/20/2015. Now, what happened was it lost compression. It would only run when you revved it up really, really high. So I was going to work and it quit on me. Made this funny noise, you could hear it, and it quit. And then I pulled it over, worked on it for a while, tried to get it going. Finally got it running, and I just revved it up really high because that's the only time it would run. Wow! Pow! And that was it. And I'll show you a couple pictures right now of what happened while I talk about it. So what happened was somewhere a needle bearing got out. I don't know where the needle bearing come from. It might have come from down inside the crankcase somewhere, but I really don't know. And this needle bearing went up into the jug and piston because it's a two-stroke, so all of that air coming in goes through the whole entire bottom side of that engine. Sucked it in. It went down the piston one time, and or maybe two, but one definitely, and it lost compression. And that's why I couldn't get it running. Then once I got it running at high RPM, revving it up, because it had higher compression then, right? The whole thing just exploded in a manner of sounding horrible. Didn't actually blow up, but as you can see by those pictures, it is very catastrophic. That little needle bearing got in there and got in between the piston and the and just ruined everything. However, all I need to do is replace the piston, probably the piston bearings and the needle bearings, and then the jug. So really, I could fix it still. And if you'd like to see it as it sits right now, today's date, by the way, is 3/25/2017. So it has been nicely packed in the shed. There it is, nicely packed. As you can see, I've been taking very good care of it. Can you see it? Uh-oh, microphone fell off. Put that back on. So can you see it? What do you mean you can't see it? It's right there. See? It is still something I want to do. I want to try to make a piston and jug because I think that would be really, really fun. So if there's somebody that wants to give me $1,000 for it, I'll sell it. Otherwise, I'm just going to hang on to it. I've done so much work to it. And it is a really fun thing to ride around. And since the only thing I need to do is fix the piston and the jug, everything else looked okay when I took it apart, but who knows. So this video, you got that off my chest, now you know what happened. Hold on, let me fix this camera. So now we're going to move on to this gear right here. So what is this? This is a Hyosung. It's a 2017. It's extremely dirty right now. I haven't washed it in some time because it's been the rainy season and I haven't had time to take good care of it, but usually it's really clean. So ignore that. But this is a Hyosung Avitar. It's a GV650 and I got it almost the day before my moped blew up. So my wife was helping me look for something bigger because the moped really just isn't a good thing to ride around every single day. It works, it's fun, but it's not an everyday driver. So we found this for pretty cheap, and the guy had it. He took really, really good care of the outside and only the outside. That's it, just the outside. The internals of this thing were just completely messed up. So the back brakes were just completely shot, dragging actually. And this sprocket was completely shot, and a few things, I don't even remember the other things. But this was the major problem. So I'm gonna show you right now, okay, as I'm describing what I'm doing, I'm gonna show you pictures from the beginning, from a year and 10 months ago. All right, so it had, when I got it, it had about 16,000 miles. That's gonna be mile zero. So mile zero, when I got it, this thing was shot, okay? I'm going by zero when I got it because it's easier for me to tell you. So I was fixing this gear, and Paul from Australia, Electro, you guys can go check out his YouTube. It does all sorts of fun things, little knit things and Stan Meyer stuff and all kinds of stuff. Really, really fun, small things. He does a really good thumb. I don't know how much he wants me to share, but you can go check his work out. So, anyway, he was watching me try to fix this. I had 1 week to fix this because my wife's parents were here, and so I could take the van. And I only have one car. I only have the motorcycle and a van. So they need the van to get into school and back. I drop them off in the morning, but they need them in the afternoon. So I have to ride this. So no moped, and I had this the day after. Or the day before blew up. So this was shot. So I'm going to tell you what was wrong with it. So you can see by these pictures, this is a hardened gear on a hardened drive shaft. Okay. So a hardened gear on a hardened drive shaft. Now, why is that a problem? Well, if you know, you can brake on this bike by using the gears. So every time you gun it, it slams one way. And every time you brake with the gears, it slams the other way. Well, the problem with that is you start, if there's any slop in this, which the guy did no maintenance, if there's any slop in this, okay, it starts eating the gears. And once it starts eating the gears, it's pretty well shot. You got to replace the entire drive output shaft of this motor, and I do not want to take this motor apart. So I had gears and things laying around, and I was going to go ahead and weld up a different thing to this and make it work, and then find out this is a casted hardened gear, and I couldn't even machine it to put a different thing on it, so I had to use the wire EDM, and then I used an old taper lock fitting, and I cut the taper lock fitting to fit a circle, and I took another piece of metal to fit around the busted, I took the profile of the worn down shaft and actually made a profile that this piece of metal fit. Then I broke that little piece of metal into three pieces so I could set it on there, and then I could slide the taper lock fitting on there, and that's how I made the taper lock fit onto the old shaft. Now the gear, what I did was I cut the original gear that came on the taper lock, and then I took the mill and cut slots in it, and then I cut the hardened gear with the EDM, because the EDM can cut the hardened gear, but it cannot cut the you know, I couldn't machine that hardened gear with like the lathe. I tried, it just did not work. So I fit those pieces together, and while I was doing that, Paul was like, "This is not going to work. You don't know what you're doing." And I was laughing, and I was like, "Trust me, it will work." Because I used to work on gears like this on conveyor equipment. So I had a good feeling this was gonna work really, really well. However, what I didn't do was put the, another helicopter. What I didn't do is put the material in there, the packing material that I was going to put in there. So this video you're about to watch right now was at 7,800 miles. So this thing lasted for 7,800 miles. Electro was, me and him made a bet that it would last, he thought it wouldn't last past 1,000. So Paul, I did a good job. So watch this video. Here it is. All right, you ready?
Yes.
All right. Oh, this guy's going to cut something now. Okay guys, here we are. It has been, I don't know, a year and a half or something, and I have put almost 7,800 miles on this, and let's have a look at how good this thing held up. So originally Paul said it was gonna fail on me within less than 1,000 miles. I said no. Now when I put this on originally,
I broke this guy off, and I think this one I was didn't want a chance, and these two tried to strip out. This was actually the only thing that held everything tight, so it eventually loosened up, which caused this to have a little bit of play in it. You can't hardly even see it. That's just the slippage here, because this piece held it tight, and so without this being held tight, it wanted to play. If I hold it out here, it's fine. It's tight. It can't rock. So to fix this, what I was originally going to do, and I'm going to go ahead and do it now, is I'm going to use... Originally, I was going to put a filler in all this, in the crevices and cracks here, a filler that would hold basically no gaps. There would be no little gaps anywhere, because originally there was tiny little gaps. Not a whole lot, but a little bit. So a while back, I bought some of this quick steel high temperature repair epoxy. Wait, I got some of this quick steel, and I'm going to go ahead and take this off, clean this up really, really well, and actually put some of this quick steel in there, which will fill in any of the gaps. And then while I got this apart, I'm going to go ahead and re-tap these holes and get some better screws to put in this guy. Yeah. Go ahead. Other than that, this has been holding up really well. It didn't mess up down here where I believe other people thought it might, but instead it messed up out here, which is actually where I thought it would fail if it was going to fail. And it's definitely nowhere near failing, but definitely need to fix it up here with some patch. Alright, cleaned these pieces up really well. I also tapped and drilled these out to 1/4-20, much bigger, better size bolt. Had some issues with the tap, broke the tap edge, and then reamed the whole hole out pretty bad, so the one hole isn't perfect, but it'll hold. And I got this all cleaned up, looks nice and good. Lots of work cleaning, because I want this stuff to stick really well. So now we're basically going to just smash all this stuff together and put this epoxy on here, and I'll probably end up putting it in the oven and heating it and getting it solid. It says it probably hardens better at a higher temperature. I don't know, so I'm probably gonna put it in the oven because it's for high temp, so it probably hardens better with higher temperature, so be a little better than just ambient, because I don't know how long it takes to set. Wow, I need to clean the oven. Anyway, it's been in the oven for several hours at about 100 degrees Fahrenheit, and then I bumped it up to 2 and then 3 and then 4, and it's been a total of about 6 hours or so baking in the oven. So I'm letting it cool right now at a room temperature, and then I'll put it on. Oh, baking gears in the oven. Alright, so here it is after it's been baked. And you see these really shiny particles on the inside of that cast? You can see I wiped it off right there. Not quite sure what those are, but they wipe off easily. I did bake it in the oven for a while, so kind of concerned about balancing it, but not really at the exact same time. So we'll wipe it down, and we can sand this and drill it, so we can balance it if we really want to, but honestly, I do not think it will make that big of a difference. It's hot, though. It's hot outside. It's 103 degrees out here. Oh, it's back together. So, I suspect that that will hold up really, really well. The only real reason it started giving me fits is because this piece wasn't held on there very tight. So this sort of holds the whole thing in place. And when that loosened up just a little, it had some play. So you gotta remember, this gear goes forward and backward because you can use the engine to slow down the bike. So it really gets a lot of oscillation like that. And that's what caused the original problem, is that it came a tiny bit loose and then it could move and then it just hammered and just completely messed it up pretty good. So, yeah, I think we're good. But, you know, can't complain for making something homemade and custom. Still gonna last a pretty long time. Thumbs up. See you guys another day. Bye.
Alright, welcome back. So now, it's been 2,500 miles later. Alright, I've put a total of 10,300 and some odd miles on this particular gear that I fixed, and it's still perfectly fine. So let me get you some close-ups now. And this is basically the end of the video. My goodness, what a lot of work. So I'll give you, this thing is so dirty, but let me show you what it is anyway. So let me show you the gear, and then I'll show you the bike. I know you guys were interested. So the gear is perfectly fine. I don't know if you can see the packing material back there, but it is still all intact. None of it's missing. I didn't try to take this off. I didn't see the need to, but it is perfectly tight. No slippage, no nothing. So yeah, I'm really excited about that because, you know, that's a major problem if you have to replace the shaft. I think the clutch is actually going funny in this thing, but it's been like that since day one, since I got it, so I'm not worried about it. It's not a real big deal. The reason I got this thing apart is because this is the third tire I've put on in 10,300 miles. The first one was a cheap tire. The second one was a, well, that was the original one. The second one, I guess the first one I put on was a cheap tire. The second one I put on is this one. This is a good, this is a battle axe made by, the cheap one, I even forgot the name, it was cheap, by Bridgestone. You can see how the tire wears. So all of the roads I drive on are crowned, and that's why this side is worn off more. I drive a lot more on this side of the bike. It's not the alignment. Every tire I've had on this bike does it. I'm pretty sure it's just the roads. If you look at the roads I drive, they're all crowned. However, I did actually use a lot of this tire. These are down pretty low, and the center's down pretty low. Normally, this side is burned off, you know, so I know that at least I used the tire pretty well. So, got a new tire put on today, and it's all nice and round. You can see the difference. This tire is, like, perfectly round, where that other tire is actually concaved on 3 points. It's kind of neat how that is. So, here's the bike as it looks. My cover keeps touching the hot muffler, so I gotta clean off this. This is just dirt from that, but it was in really good shape when I got it. I'm very pleased with it. It's actually a, most people have never seen a Hyosung, and especially an orange one, it's kind of a rare. This particular bike in this color is more rare. They do have windshields for these. I'd love to get one, but I just can't afford it. I can barely afford the maintenance on this thing. Keep it going. I gotta do it all myself. And yeah, I changed that tire myself. You can see the live stream where I struggled through it. Yeah. I don't know. I ain't got much else to say. It's an Avitar. It's a Hyosung. It's a unique bike. I'll show you the mileage since the last time. So 10,300. Oh, that's the light. Anyway, I can't. Oh, I guess I do just push it. There we go. All right, so 27,000. I'm pretty sure it had 20 or it had 16 when I got it. So that's about right. 16 something. Maybe it had 17. Must have had 17. I have not reset trip A since I bought it. That's where I know where I'm at. But this is actually a pretty nice bike. A lot of this is plastic. This is plastic. This is plastic. But these all are actually chrome pieces. So there's quite a bit of chrome. People ask me that is this a Harley V-Rod? Which is one of my favorite bikes. I really like the way the curved pipes come out and look. But I've never driven one, so I can't tell you if I really like it. But this bike is got a lot of chrome on it for cheap. This bike originally only costs $14,000, I think, brand new. And this being a 2007. And the saddlebags are not factory. Those came with it, but I made some. I actually made these brackets that go on here. So you can see how they hang on there. They get bolted where the chrome piece used to be. It's pretty nice. Anyway, yeah, this guy's been sitting over here, and I will fix it. I really do want to fix it again, because I really enjoy driving that thing around. But the maintenance on this guy, man, I just burned through tires going up and down. I've been posting a lot of live drives, not live stream drives, but I've been posting a lot of drives on this, on my RWG Research Live YouTube channel. So if you'd like to hang out with me on the bike, I've just been testing camera angles and different things because I want to go on a fun ride somewhere and I want to get that good angle. So I've been playing with it. So there's a couple trips on there you might like. I did put the exact same headlight that I did in the moped, except this one's not haggardly wired. It accepts the DC voltage and works really well. But yeah, that's all I got for you. I hope it wasn't too long of a video. I hope it was actually interesting and worth watching. But that's all. Now I'm going to put this thing back together and call it a day. So peace and love. Now you guys know what happened to the moped. And now you know what I got. When I bought this, like I said, it was 2 years ago, a year and 10 months. And this is actually a crotch rocket style motor packed into a cruiser looking bike. So Hyosung makes, I think, Suzuki engines or something. And so they've been around for a manufacturer for like a long, long, 25 years or something. So they make the motor, and then they built bikes over the last X amount of years, and this is one of the versions. So this is kind of a rare model. This came from Korea. It's a Korean bike. And the dumbest thing that I've ever seen in my life is the reason that I had such a big problem with this gear is because this belt is, I believe, a 3 millimeter pitch. Don't quote me on that because I don't remember. It's been over a year and 10 months since I looked it up. But this is a Gates belt. You cannot buy it from Gates. 3 millimeter pitch is specific for companies who want to charge their customers lots of money for this custom size belt. So Gates makes 2 millimeter and 4 millimeter and 8 and probably other ones. I really don't remember, but I remember this being something like a 3 millimeter pitch. I think it was 3 millimeter. Don't quote me on that now. But it's a rare one, and you cannot just buy it. Very frustrating. Probably not 3, it's probably something else, because this is way too big. Nonetheless, that was a bit weird. So, to get some of these parts, you know, apparently you can buy this whole entire motor for pretty cheap from Australia, Paul was telling me. But to get a motor shipped from Australia just for the drive shaft, you know, replace the whole motor. But anyway, all right, I'll let you guys go. Hopefully you like this video, and now you know what's going on. And I finally revealed the bike. If you guys want to watch me, or if you want me to post more drives on my main channel, I'm trying to get a good audio so I can talk to you while I drive, but I don't really drive different places. It's always the same boring drive. But if you want me to drive and talk about my thoughts, I like to watch other people drive their motorcycles and talk about their thoughts. So if that's something you like, let me know. Peace. Have a good day. I gotta put this thing together. And if you've never seen zip ties and tires being put on, you should go watch the live stream recorded video. All right. See you guys later in another video.